Hi, I'm meteorologist Chris Tomer. Let's talk mountain weather and ski conditions. And we'll start off first at Whistler Blackcomb. I think this is the place to be on Sunday and also Monday with this storm system coming in. And that's what I'm going to focus on here is this next storm system, really spring skiing across the west. We're kind of waiting on the next storm system, and I'll show it to you here in a sec. So that is Whistler Blackcomb here, Schweitzer. I think this next storm will kind of just brush Schweitzer with an inch or two of snow. I don't think this is going to be a big storm, unfortunately for the Schweitzer area, but it will drop down into the interior of the U.S. By early next week. So we'll talk all about it, and it's really just one storm system. Look at the west right now. It is high and it is dry across parts of across parts of the west. Colorado had a storm roll through yesterday, last night, and so today it's actually a very good day in the mountains of Colorado with some snow and colder temperatures. But this is the storm that I'm watching right here. You see the flow? See the clouds? Basically just like a fire hose hitting British Columbia right now. So all of that is going to start to drop south and center and hit Whistler Blackcomb, and also it's going to push moisture over the top of Banff, Western Banff. A lot of that area should get some good snow. So, and then it will drop down into Rainier and Baker and a lot of those places. So we've got some good snow ahead for the Pacific Northwest, and it's just really following the jet. The jet is just blowing the moisture into the coast right now. So that's the current state of it. You can see how it drops down the low. There's a little dip right here. And by the time we get into Monday, Tuesday, the low is sitting somewhere right in here. I'll mark it. And that's the low that has dropped out of the Pacific Northwest that will bring the snow to the Pacific Northwest. Well, that's going to drop into the interior Monday, Tuesday, and then it will slide through. And by Wednesday, it's already kind of Colorado and then moving east at that point. Now, after that moves through, there's not a lot of action. So we're really just kind of looking at this one storm system. All right, let's look at the future radar here so you can kind of see how this plays out. Watch the blue up around Whistler, BC, up into Banff. So by tonight into Sunday morning, we start to see that snow already moving into Whistler and a lot of those areas. And then by the time we go from Sunday into Monday, here comes the front. And the snow's dropping south through, again, just kind of brushing Schweitzer, but down towards Sun Valley, Big Sky. It will roll through Jackson Hole, but only brush the Wasatch. This is pretty fast moving, and it will not, the Wasatch will not receive a direct hit from this. It will kind of just brush and move on by pretty quick. So that is Tuesday right here at 5. Look how quickly that thing has moved. It's so fast moving, it's going to be hard to drop big snow on its way south. But, I mean, by the time we get to Tuesday morning, it is moving through Colorado, but by the time we get to Wednesday, I mean, it's almost out of here. And look at the west at that point. Big high pressure settling in, really, talk about spring skiing at that point. I think that's going to be the case. All right, so as far as accumulation goes, by the time we get into Sunday morning, we've already potentially accumulated 4 to 8 inches across Whistler in BC. Then between Sunday and Monday, here come the big numbers rolling in. I mean, we're working on 2 feet. Whistler, BC, down to Baker, Rainier, Stevens Pass. So Monday's going to be prime in the Pacific Northwest for that. And look at the numbers over towards Revelstoke and Marmot Basin, Sunshine Village, and Fernie. I mean, we're looking at like 5 to 12 inches in those areas by Monday morning. So that's going to be good. And then that snow races south into Discovery. And by the time we go from Monday into Tuesday, we've added anywhere from 4, 5, 6 inches in Jackson Hole, Big Sky, Bridger Bowl. And we've added a little bit in Colorado by Tuesday. And then we'll reach our peak numbers by Wednesday morning in Colorado. And it's not going to be huge in Colorado. I mean, what am I forecasting? 2 to 6 inches in most of those places. And look at the numbers in the Wasatch as this races through. We're really not seeing big numbers there. It just kind of brushes it with maybe 1 to 3 inches of accumulation. But that is the storm. It's one storm. At least there's something there. I hope you have a great weekend and enjoy it. And always appreciate you tuning in here.